This is DigiStyle with Kylie Bartlett.
Welcome back to DigiStyle. I've got Jovana Vojnic with me, CEO of Bumper Leads. Welcome to the show.
Hey, thank you. Thanks for having me.
Second guest, doing well. And it's great that I've got a background working with you. So I was so excited to be given the opportunity to interview you. Now, I know all about your backstory. It is fascinating how you actually started Bumper Leads. So please tell us, who are you? What do you do? And give us a little bit of an insight into what you've done and where you are today.
Oh, thank you for having me today, Kylie. My name is Jovana Vojnic, and a lot of people actually struggle to pronounce
Vojnic.
That. So I often introduce myself as Jovana Coffee, because that's how it sounds.
So oh, I love it.
People remember that.
Jovana Coffee, you've never told me that before.
Jovana Coffee.
I like that.
And so I founded Bumper Leads. We are a marketing automation agency that works with small businesses, whether you're e-commerce, consultant, coach, and we help you grow your sales, inquiries, and profit.
Oh, I like the sound of that.
So we focus on automation, but what we focus on is humanizing technology. So having that ability to bring that customer experience, as in face to face, have that online.
It sounds very nerdy.
It is very nerdy.
So I want to hear, tell me, because I know the backstory, and I think that when you hear the backstory, what it does is gives people hope that they can do it too, because this wasn't always your world. So give me a little bit about, where have you come from and what made you become a specialist in marketing automation?
Yes, look, I was in corporate world. I was stuck in corporate for 12 years, working in supply chain and procurement. One day I was really bored in my job, as many of your viewers might be doing the same thing, and I ended up just looking for a business to buy, because I didn't really think that starting a business.
How long ago was this? About,
this is about 2013.
Okay, so about 7 years ago.
Yeah, 7 years ago.
In Australia?
In Australia, yes.
Mm-hmm.
And I ended up buying a business for nothing. This business was doing about $1 million, and I ended up buying it for nothing.
Really?
Came with the stock. It was national.
So it was a traditional offline business.
It was a traditional offline.
I think that's important
business.
That it wasn't already online. It was offline.
Yes. It's important when you look at buying a business in the first place, is that what can you bring? What kind of value can you bring into the business?
And you, can you tell us what industry that is in?
It's an interesting industry. It's an alcohol industry.
So there's some kind of little trend going on here with Kyler being an alcohol, me, champagne lover, and now you're telling me your first business.
It's a very unique alcohol spirits from that people don't really know, but it's, I don't know if you've ever drank a cocktail.
Caipirinha,
do you know caipirinha?
Yes.
So there is a spirit called cachaça, a Brazilian spirit, cachaça, that goes in, and we had our own brand.
Fantastic. So it was a traditional offline...
offline business. And I remember when I got the keys to the business, I heard crickets. It was nothing. Because I realized the person who I bought the business from had the database of clients on his phone, and he was overseas.
Yep.
And there was no way to reach customers.
So you got a lemon at the moment.
So I really started from the bottom.
Yeah.
I got a lemon. But in the end, I realized that I had this massive opportunity. There was a database of 10,000 potential customers.
Right.
All we had to do was just reactivate that database.
Right. And now this is where you brought in the marketing automation online.
Exactly. I've rebranded. I have introduced technology. And I've realized that after introducing this marketing automation concept, and started collecting leads, whether the leads are coming from the website organically or it's paid leads,
mm-hmm.
they come into your database, which is, I always say, it's a body of an octopus.
Nice.
Website is a body of, and then all the tentacles are really the ways people come in contact with you.
Okay, touch points, yeah?
These are all touch points, and the idea is that you have that one-on-one relationship with the customer, which is your database.
Great. So that business, the beverage business, the alcohol business, you've now gone and used it to cut your teeth on it. So you've gone and learned all about marketing.
Yeah.
You implemented it in this business, and what happened as a result?
What happened is within 3 months, I sold all my stock with just 3 different emails that I promoted.
Unbelievable.
Instead of, the alternative was hiring a salesperson to door knock every restaurant and sell one case. That's usually the...
And so you automated and
were
able to...
And so I automated and I sold more.
Sold it all, 3 months.
By spending less.
And so then it got you hooked on marketing.
Yeah, people used to ask me, how did you do it? I only worked 10 hours a week. Everything was there. System was working. So then I realized that there is an opportunity to teach others and to help other businesses do the same.
To do the same. So what are you seeing, Ivana, on going on online? Like, where do you see people making their biggest mistakes when launching a website or adding e-commerce to their business?
The biggest mistake I see people do is they'll spend a lot of money in building a website,
yes,
a beautiful website. And I often say, it's, you know, you're not building a website to win design awards. We want to win customers as well.
Why not? Nice.
And so a lot of people spend that money and then they wait for customers to come.
And it doesn't happen.
And then they realize, oh, I do need to invest in paid advertising. Now,
yes,
I'm going to go in and hire an agency to help me find customers.
Yes.
And so oftentimes you'll spend a lot of money trying to find the right customer. And that's where people fail, because they tend to not focus on who the customer is.
Yes.
Who is your customer? What do you actually want to do with that customer? How do you want that life cycle, that purchasing life cycle to work? And so oftentimes we help people actually realize what's important.
Yeah.
And we build a system of what they want to do before, during and after.
So having a bit of a strategy, well, not even a bit of, a lot of strategy, kind of to map out that end-to-end process,
yes,
the customer journey.
Do we, you call work? It, yeah, the customer journey or a digital roadmap, and then we implement the system behind it so that you have the website that becomes like an employee. It's almost like a 24/7 employee for you, and you could go and invest in more paid advertising, but you are going to be reducing the cost to,
yes,
acquire the customer, because,
yes,
you're not going to be spending money on something that doesn't work.
So can I ask you a question around email marketing, EDM, as we heard Kyla say, electronic,
yes,
direct mail?
Yes.
You know, some people would say that email marketing is dead because of social. What are your thoughts on that?
Yes, I think 10 years ago, EDM or email marketing worked really well. You could send one email and you would be making a lot of money. Nowadays, you have to be a bit more smart. You have to be dynamic. You have to know and understand your customers better. So segmentation becomes important. And that's what marketing automation is, that next level.
So let's, I know you're a big nerd on these techo terms, but segmentation, what does that mean?
Segmentation means that if you want to send a message to your customer, you send it based on a behavior.
Uh-huh.
So it could be when they place an order, you send a message.
Something triggers, so when they place an order, something,
yeah,
triggers.
If this happens, do this.
That does, okay.
Or not do this. So if something, if a customer doesn't do something, you don't have to always send them an email.
Yes.
You can send your sales staff an email to say follow up, because Joe or Giovanna was on the website 5 times looking at champagne. And is it better to send an email? Maybe not. Maybe a sales rep should call them, because Giovanna is hot enough for the...
So this is like people like sometimes me, I'll put things in a shopping cart and then I'm like, well, I don't know if I really want it. And so then I don't go through with the order. What happens is this, a system can pick that up.
Yeah, a system can pick that up, definitely. They can see what exactly you had in your basket. They could send you...
Really? Even
messages.
Though I empty it out, I can,
yes,
still see what's in it?
Yes. Yes, that's freaky.
Thinking about Big Brother looking over my shoulder. So they literally, because it's tracking for things that are going,
exactly,
into the basket, and then when I,
yeah,
exit without...
you exit. And we actually find that 30% of customers who abandon the cart, that's what we call it, techie.
Abandon the cart.
Abandon the cart. 30% will actually come back after you send them an email.
That's like, interesting. So you're saying,
time.
You're saying with 30% you can capture that sale,
yes,
back in.
Yes.
But what normally happens? Do people normally have this system in place?
Not by default. And a website designer is not going to think that. So a website designer will build a beautiful website, but they're not going to think about how to get more sales through the door to your website.
Yeah, interesting. So can I ask you about social media now that it's so big?
Yeah.
Are you able to capture leads through social media? Does that become part of your automation?
Yes, definitely. If you are promoting anything, even today, if we're promoting something today, the idea is that you send your audience or give them something of value, give them something of free.
Yes.
Something that doesn't cost a lot of money for you to make.
Yes.
And you just ask for a first name and email address.
Like a lead magnet.
It's a lead magnet.
Uh-huh.
So that's another techie term, but I'm not sure how many people know. It's an incentive. I always say,
give me your name and email address, and in return, I'll,
yeah,
give you something.
It has to be something that is highly desirable, but easily digestible,
yeah,
by your audience.
And so what are your thoughts on Facebook Messenger, using that as a part of your marketing? I notice more and more that when I follow a page on Facebook, I'm getting this instant message coming through on Messenger. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, Facebook, they're innovating, they're getting into that AI, so they're knowing, they're really innovating in the automation space. So Facebook Messenger is just another channel for you to be optimizing as a business. So
one last question I'm going to ask you around, you said AI, and then you also mentioned at the start of the interview about human, the human element. So are you saying that you're bringing in HI, like human intelligence. Not just artificial intelligence? So talk to me about that side, because how do you do that with automation?
Well, a lot of people, you can humanize a lot of technology by bringing pictures of yourself or personalizing the experience.
Great. Which Same as what Kylie was saying.
Telling stories, videos, and messages, you know, the type of message that you want to share. And it has to be relevant, obviously.
Fabulous. So just one last question. Where can we find you? We're about to wind up. How can we find you? How do we follow you? How can we learn more?
Oh, great. So our website is bumperleads.com.
Yes.
And all your viewers can actually download, if they want to learn more about marketing automation, they can go to bumperleads.com/tasks. And they can download 30 marketing automation tasks they can basically implement in their business right now.
Thank you so much, Ivana. What a fantastic first episode. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I've enjoyed bringing it to you. So be sure to let us know how you're doing it digi-style. Follow us across social media, and I'll see you all back here next Monday. Bye for now.